Welcome students, in this video we are going to define what is binary encoding system in our digital computer system. In general, encoding means to convert any number, character, anything into a specific format by some specific group of symbol. Encoding means changing one value, that is, suppose our we have one number 1, 2, 3. If we say 1 is represented by A, 2 is B and 3 is C, then if we say ABC, ABC is an encoded form of 1, 2, 3. So whenever we give 2, 1, 3, then for 2 we can write B, for A we can write A, for C we can write C. So this is the encoding format. Encoding format means for every digits or every character there must be some specific symbol. This is the encoding format. Okay. So here also in binary number system there are some encoding value. So yes, it is digital data, so the encoding value is must be group of binary bits. Okay, if in our normal system we can represent it either by ABC 1, 2, 3 or any other symbol, square, rectangle, anything, but as it is in digital data the encoding symbol must be in group of binary bits. Okay, so this group is known as binary code. And the binary code is represented by a number as well as alphanumeric results. That means any number or any alphanumeric letter can also be changes into binary code. Okay. So what are the advantage of binary code? Advantage of binary code is binary codes are suitable for computer application. Computer application means if we converted the data by any means, then it will be suitable. We can see it in when we are discuss what is the proper different binary codes, we get understand. Okay, the binary codes are suitable for digital communication. Binary codes is make, analyze and digital circuits drawing. It is very easy if we use binary codes, and since only 0 and 1 are being used, implementation becomes easy. So there are different classification of binary codes: weighted code, non-weighted code, alphanumeric codes. Weighted code means, what is weighted code? Weighted code means that suppose in decimal number system if we write 1, 2, 3, so 1 is unit, 2 is tens and 3 is thousand, unit 10,000. So for every digits in any binary number has its place value. If any number has its place value, then that is known as weighted codes. So 1, 2, 3 can be represented as it. So unit means we can say its power is 10 to the power 0, 10 to the power 1, 10 to the power 2, as we do in our binary number system. This is 0, 1, 2. So 1, 2, 3 can be written as 1 into 10 to the power 2 plus 2 into 10 to the power 1 plus 3 into 10 to the power 0. So you can see that every digit has some place value. Okay, so that is known as its weighted code. So in binary number also every digit has place value. What it means? Suppose 101, it is 0 position, 1 position, 2 position. That means first place value is 1 into 2 to the power 2 plus 0 into 2 to the power 1 plus 1 into 2 to the power 0. So what it is place value? So in binary number system for place value 101, first place value is 2 to the power 0. That means 1. Second place value is 2 to the power 1, that means 2. Third place value is 2 to the power 2, that means 4. Okay. So its place value is 1, 2, 4. That means 1 into 4, 0 into 2 plus 1 into 1. All the digits are multiplied by its place value. We know that how to convert any binary number into decimal number. So, all the digits is multiplied by its place value and we get the original number, that is we get 5. Okay. So, this is weighted code. Weighted code means if every digit has its place value, then that is known as binary code. Okay. One type of place value binary coding system, encoding system, normally every binary number has a weighted value. So, for encoding system, weighted place value is known as binary coded BCD code. BCD code is an encoding value of binary number. Mind it. What is BCD code? BCD code is a weighted code, okay, which is an encoding format used in our digital data. So, how we get binary code of a number? BCD code means binary code. So, binary codes means each decimal digits is represented, each decimal digit is represented by a 4-bit binary number. Mind it. Each decimal digit is represented by a 4-bit binary digits. Okay, that means suppose there is a decimal digits 4 and 5, it is decimal digit. Okay. In normal case, if we convert it into binary number system, then what we should do? We have to divide it like this way, 2 to 4, like this way. You all know how to convert decimal number in binary number. But if we convert any decimal number in BCD code, then each digit, that means 5 and 4, there are two digits, each digit should be represented by 4-bit binary number. Okay, that means normally binary number of 5 is 101. Okay, so we need 4-bit binary number. So for 5 we have to write 0101. Okay, for 4, 4 value is 100. You have a table of decimal to binary number, you can get this value. 4 is 100, but we know in BCD code every binary digit should be represented by 4 bits. So, we have to write 4 for 0100. Okay, so the BCD code of 45 is this total value BCD. We cannot write here base 2 because this is not binary value. This is BCD form of 45. This is not binary value. Okay, if we change this into binary value, we get another different value, binary number. So for BCD number, every decimal digits, each decimal digit has to be converted into 4-bit binary digits. Okay, so maximum, how many number of digits are there in decimal number system? There are 0 to 9 digits. So 0 to 9 digits can be converted into binary coded decimal. That means if we want 1 2, it should be recorded two separate 2 digits. We cannot take 12 as an whole digits. Okay, if we write 15, we have to take 15 as 2 digits number. We can't take 15 as a whole digit. So, in BCD number, then each digit should be represented from 0 to 9. So, the table in BCD form, we can get 0 to 9. There are 10 digits in decimal number system. So, and every digit should be in 4 digit number. That means, suppose I am giving an example, suppose 1, 2. 2 binary number is 1, 2. Binary of 2 is 10. Binary of 1 is 1. We know that But for 2, we have to write 4 digits. So, for 2, we have to write 0010 individually. 2, for 2, we have to write 4 bits. And for 1, we have to write 0001. Okay. So, these are total is the BCD form of 1, 2. And as we know that for every number, there are 4 bits, any number, 4 bits. So, for first value, every digit has its position. For the first position, it is 2 to the power 0. For the second, it is 2 to the power 1. For the third, it is 2 to the power 2. For the fourth, is 2 to the power 3. Okay. So, 2 to the power 0 means 1. 2 to the power 1 means 2. 2 to the power 2 means 4. 2 to the power 3 means 8. So, for every BCD number, every digit's place value, the 4 digit place value is 8421. So, BCD number is also known as 8421 code as its place value. Okay. You can see here weights 8421 for every digits, and we get the number by multiplying this one I have discussed before. So, this is our weighted value. So, weighted value, from weighted value we get the number by multiplying its position in the number. Okay. Now, there are two non-weighted codes. One is excess 3 code and another is gray code. In excess 3 code, mind it, in excess 3 code, we get the 3 code BCD number for each binary bits. We get the excess 3 code by adding 3, 0, 0, 1, 1. That means, just I am giving an example, suppose we have a number 0001, okay. For every binary number, if we add 0011, 001 means 3 in decimal, we get the access code. That means 0110110011. Any binary number, suppose we have a binary number 10, but in BCD code 10 must be written as 00. That's why it is told as BCD code, not binary code. For BCD code, suppose 0010, if we add 0 with this 0011, we get access 3 code. Okay. So, for access 3 code means any decimal digits, convert it into BCD number, then add 0011 with each number, we get access 3 code. Access 3 means we have to add 3. The binary of 3 is 0011 in 4 digit number. Everything should be done with 4 bit number. Okay. You can see here, this is every 0 to 9. BCD means for every number should be represented at 4 bit, and if we add this BCD form 0011, we get access 3 code. So, this code does not have any place value, because if we convert 0011, we get 3. So, this is not a number. So, by getting its weighted value, we cannot retrieve the original number. That's why it has no not weighted value. Gray code is also a non-weighted code. There is a technique used in gray code which is not needed for yourself. The XOR operation used in gray code, but I can explain here. One thing for gray code is that for every gray code, for any two consecutive gray code, this is a list of gray code for 0 to 9. For every two consecutive gray code, there always be one bit changes. Suppose you can see any number you take, suppose 6 and 7, for 6 is this, 7 is this, that means 6 is 0101, 7 is 0100. These are two gray code, this is for 6, this is for 7. Okay, you can see that why I am saying that it is one bit change. You can see these are same, these are same, these are same, only one bit is change. वी कैन गेट दिस ग्रे कोड बाय यूजिंग एक्स और ऑपरेशन ऑफ बीसीडी कोड. वी डोंट नीड दैट हाउ टू गेट ग्रे कोड. जस्ट यू हैव टू नो दैट एनी टू कंसेक्यूटिव ग्रे कोड नंबर देयर इज वन बिट चेंज ऑलवेज. सपोज आई टेक 3 and 4. फॉर 3 ग्रे कोड नंबर इज 0010. फॉर 4 ग्रे कोड नंबर इज 0110. Here you can also see these are same, these are same, these are same, only these are change. So always to, for any two consecutive number, one digits are change. Okay, that's why this is known as only one bit changes at a time. Gray code is also known as unit distance code. You have to remember this. What is unit distance code? Unit distance code is gray code, and gray code is a non-weighted code. Okay. Now alphanumeric code. What is alphanumeric code? Alphanumeric code means, suppose in our computer system, in keyboard there are different type of keys, A, B, C, D, any. You can see any type of symbol, question mark, comma, space bar, everything. But computer could not understand this A, B, C, D. So every character in our keyboard has to be converted into its binary form. Okay, so every character, every number, every digits, everything has to be converted into its binary form. So there must be some specific rule to convert every character in keyboard into its binary form. There are two methods used for this conversion. One is ASCII code and another is IPSEDIC code. Okay, ASCII code is America Standard Code for Information Interchange. These codes are same all over the world, and IPSEDIC code, extended binary coded interchange information. ASCII codes are 7 bit code and IPSEDIC code are 8 bit code. Okay, so in our ASCII code, in our ASCII codes, capital A is represents as, we cannot convert A into binary form. So for every character in our keyboard, there must be some unique number which has to be, is to be converted into its binary form whenever, in order to understand by digital circuit. So A, ASCII value of A is 65, capital ASCII value of A is 65. So 65 can be easily converted into binary number system. This value is same in all over the world. This can be checked using our C program also, ASCII value. Okay, in ASCII value internally, A cannot be taken for granted. A cannot understand by our computer system. So computer system can understand this number because this number can be converted into binary number system. That's why we need some specific value for every character. In even space also have some specific ASCII value. So capital A's value is 65, and in our consequence, consecutively B, capital B is 66, like this way. Okay, small A ASCII value is 97, obviously small B 98, like this way. Okay, in keyboard character, 0 is represented as 48. You can say 0 is a binary digit, so why we should need ASCII value of 0? For every, I am saying that for every keyboard character, there must be some specific value, because computer could not understand that these 0 and our binary number system 0 are same. Only this 0 is 0, 2, 3, 4, every digits in our keyboard is just an symbol for computer. So that's why the for computer 0 value, the ASCII value is 48, and like way 1 is 49, like this way. Okay, these are all ASCII value. So whenever it is converted into binary number system, for capital A 65 must be converted into number system, into binary number system by dividing it 2, and that must be 7 bits character ASCII value. So for ASCII value we get 2 to the power 7 this number of character through ASCII code. We can get 2 to the power 7. 2 to the power 7 means 128 character can be obtained in ASCII value. Okay, so ASCII value is a 7 bits code. For in 7 bit code we get combination of 128 binary number system. So for 128 binary number can be easily obtained in ASCII value. Like this way there is also an value IPSIDIC value, extended binary coded decimal information interchange code. So if for IPSIDIC value we need, in general ASCII value is taken in our considerations, okay, mind it. But this is for your short questions, we need it. What is IPSIDIC value, full form of IPSIDIC value, how many bits are there? IPSIDIC value uses 8 bits to represent a single character. So for 8 bits in IPSIDIC value we get 2 to the power 8, that means 256 character can be represented in IPSIDIC value. These are the difference of ASCII value and IPSIDIC value. Okay, ASCII value is most efficient way and it is mostly used. IPSIDIC value is not used because it is not, most cases it is not compatible with our system. Okay, binary encoding system can be done in our digital electronic system. Okay.